Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are happy and healthy. So dear students, as you can see, today we are going to study the perfect continuous. So let's see. Very first, we have mentioned about helping verb. In this tense, we use helping verb has been and have been. Okay students, in present perfect continuous tense, we use helping verb has been and have been. And I and we join ing in the first form of the main verb. Okay, if we talk about the difference between have been and have been, so I have taught you already in the present perfect tense. With he, she, it and singular noun we use has been, and you, we, they, I and plural noun take have been. Okay, now we will discuss the structures of present perfect continuous tense. So very first, affirmative sentence. So here we talk about the affirmative sentence. So in affirmative sentence, very first we mention subject, after that helping verb has been and have been, then been, ing form of the verb, object, and after that we mention since and for, then time. Okay, so this is the structure of affirmative sentence. You can see some example also. It has been raining since morning. So dear students, you can see has been plus ing form of the verb refer that the sentence is present perfect continuous tense. The teacher has been teaching for 2 hours. So has been plus teaching, that is the ing form of the verb, shows that this is present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. Okay, and moreover, generally we use since and for in present perfect continuous tense generally. Okay, after that we will discuss after negative sentence. Let's see. Negative sentence. So students, as usual we know in negative sentence, we also mention subject very first, and after that helping verb has or have, and after the helping verb we mention negative or not, then been, then ing form of the verb, then we use object, and after that since or for, then. Okay, you can see the example. She has not been studying for 2 days. Okay students, so you can see the helping verb has been and studying ing form of the verb tells that this is a present perfect continuous tense, and the negative or not tells that this is a negative sentence. Okay dear students, now see in the negative sentence. Okay, so here if we talk about imperative sentence, so case number first, begins with the helping verb. Okay, friends, begins with the helping verb. You can say yes or no type question. So in this format, very first we listen helping verb or has, then subject will come, then ing form of the verb, object, since or form, plus time. And as is what in the negative sentence, we don't mark off punctuation. You can see the example. The farmers been working in the field since morning. Okay, so you can see the sentence is starting with helping verb have. Okay, and at last you can see the mark of integration. So this says that this is integrative sentence, and being and ing from the verb shows that this is present perfect continuous tense. So dear, I hope you have got this all points very well. Now let's see the second case of infinitive sentence. Okay. If we talk the second case, so in second case, begins with question word. WS family, we can say. So student, when the sentence begins with question word, WS family, so the question word will come very fast. And after that, case 1, okay, case 1, so question 1 and case 1, has or have, subject, been, be, then, ing form of verb, object, then, since or for, after that, time, and as usual mark of integration. So, this is your integrative sentence structure of second case. Okay? You can see the example. Why had he crying for two hours? Why I see this, I have mentioned here to forget. I have forgot to mention the why has he been trying to write for 2 hours. Okay, so you can see this is the example of integrative sentence of present perfect continuous tense. okay? Sentence is beginning with WS family, okay? Helping verb has plus been and ing form. So this all tells that this is an interrogative sentence or present perfect continuous tense. Okay? After that, student, I will tell you the use of since and for. So I hope you have got this all points very well. Note down, then I will teach you the use of since and for. Since and for. So you can make two columns. Students, generally we use since with point of time. Point of time is a given, then we use since. Okay, we use since. And with period of time, we use for. Okay, we use for. So let's see point of time. So in point of time, the part of the day, part of the day, like since morning, evening, afternoon. Okay? Afternoon. If we talk about the second use, before the name of date. Okay, before the name of the age. Like since Monday, Tuesday. Okay, many more. If we talk about the third use, before the years. More than years, okay? Like since 2018, 2020, many more, it is, okay? Okay? Like since 2 o'clock. Okay? Since 2 o'clock, since 3 o'clock, such like. So if in this cases we use since, and if it talks about the for. So before the dates. You put the number of days, like for 2 days, for 5 days. So this is the number of days. Okay? You can see the second rule. Before the number of week hours month year. What is this? So we use for before the number of weeks, number of before the number of months and before the number of years. Okay? You can see example. For 3 weeks. Okay? For 2 hours. 2 hours. For 4 months, for 20 years. Okay, students. So I hope you have got the usage of for and the usage of since. We use for before the number of days and before the number of weeks, of months and years. Okay, students. So dear, I hope you have got this all points very well. Till then, watch the video and enjoy.